Oh, sorry.
No, I'm sorry. My head's in this force protection plan.
A handful of Pearl Harbor survivors are attending the ceremony this week. Not one of them under 95 years old.
Wow. Probably the last year most of them will be able to make it. 80th anniversary. Amazing.
Totally amazing. But between the threat assessment and about 1,000 meetings that should have just been emails, my body's about tapped out.
Oh, come on. Time to show them that it's go muscle, not show muscle.
How are you this jaunty?
Oh, it's not because I ate all of Ernie's chocolate espresso beans. Because I didn't. Not all of them.
Careful, Luce. I will blackmail you into doing the rest of my security interviews.
You know that's not the worst assignment, right?
One code breaker has worked tirelessly to crack encrypted Japanese messages. They managed to reveal details for the invasion of Midway Island and help shift the tide of the war. Follow me.
Wow. Who would whistle her tee off to pull the short straw on that assignment?
Maybe they chose her because she's smart and knows history. Besides, what do you actually know about the attack on Pearl Harbor? Hmm?
Over 3,000 casualties, 19 ships lost their damage, and not many people know this, but 68 civilians were killed that day. PHRD Planning Committee?
Going over protective service details for the commemoration before we get back to the cold case.
Oh, please don't use that term.
Protective service details?
No, cold case.
They're like turtlenecks. You know, once you get in them, they never really work out the way you want it.
All right, well, love it or hate it, there's no statute of limitations on murder. Our victim was shot to death and washed up in this cave.
Anyone want to guess how long ago?
Dude, just tell us.
73 to 80 years ago.
Lucy, how did you pull that number?
Am I wrong?
No, you're like eerily right. Carbon dating puts them at that range.
Well, details of the trousers. Textile analysis says it's cotton. From what I can tell, this particular uniform was in use from the 30s to 1948, except black shoes were more widely worn starting spring of 1941.
I'm impressed, but also so curious.
I went down a military rabbit hole when I found out Coco Chanel designed the Turks' uniforms.
Don't suppose we found the nameplate on the victim?
Not that lucky. It's gonna be hard to identify the victim.
Commander Chase was able to extract the DNA, but it may not be enough to ID the victim on its own.
Well, this particular uniform with the black shoes were only worn by non-aviation officers and chiefs.
Lucy, check the archives for any missing personnel that match that profile and that date range.
Can't we run the DNA against one of those ancestry databases?
Good idea. Get Ernie on it.
Maybe you should give turtlenecks another shot.
Get out of here.